This program is rated 16. Parental guidance is advised.
Be a very special day. We are doing our Independence Day special for Salon Talk. Welcome to the show. My name is Mary Luswata. As always, we are at Spectra Salon and Spa, and please, you can pass by whenever it is you're ready to get pampered. Now, joining us to do our Independence Day special is the lovely Hi. Good to see you. You were waiting for me to say your name.
Man, I was wondering. Let's see.
I love your name, Basuta.
Basuta.
You see, if a man called me Basuta, chances are I would accept. I am lying. It can't even come out of my mouth. And another guest on the show. If I was given 10,000 shillings every time somebody asked me if this man was my father, I would have like a mansion somewhere in Kololo. I would be living large. I would be rich. Philip Luswata is joining us on the show today. Good to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Have you ever been asked?
Might be my daughter.
But have you had this question where they say, this girl who makes noise on TV, is she your daughter?
Well, yeah. But you might be.
DNA insist.
You never know.
Good to have you, Tony. Would you,
What are you going to call me?
No, let me just call you that. Maybe later. But is there anything you want me to call you?
No, I have a problem. When I want to relate, people quickly want me to become their grandfather.
That's why I say
could
Tony.
Which could mean lost opportunities, you know?
Oh, man.
So I could now play the role of grandfather, however disadvantageous it may be.
Oh,
thank you very much.
It might put you in a position where you don't kufuna.
No, okay.
Anyway, guys, so we just want you to join this conversation. Yeah, Independence Day is just around the corner, and we thought, why not have a conversation about Independence Day? Besides, I was tasked as being part of Vision Group to actually deliberately talk about Independence Day. So, yeah. Chances are, I would have been talking about something else. But you see, that's the attitude that we young people have. Yeah, Independence Day. From the history books, we are told that there was a ninja called Obote, that he threw out people and he took our nation and gave it back to us. But yeah, that's like how I envision it in my mind, that Obote was a young man. And yeah, you've read the history books. But we want to hear from somebody who will tell us exactly. He says he was not born yet, but he has read the history books and he looks the part.
Oh, yes, definitely.
Yeah, that's really what matters, that he looks the part. but then, as young people, we want to task you today to really tell us why you have reduced this very, very important day to just a day where you, the night before, you make sure that the night before you party after party after party after party, you heavily party, then that on Independence Day, you don't even have the energy to put your head up to see where Museveni is celebrated, where you can't be bothered. When did Independence Day turn into just a day where we reduce it to just a public holiday and just have fun and just chill, stay at work, just stay off from work, just a day for us to chill at home? Tony, take me through the events that led up to Independence Day. Let's start from the beginning of the beginning.
try not to forget anything. Let not your memory
be. Telling you now.
Luswata, let me warn you. My hard disk has unlimited capacity. Don't be taken by appearances. Well. I think independence cannot be as crucial a day as it was 58 years ago. Yeah. It just can't be. Because this is an annual remembrance of something that is 58 years old.
Yeah.
Or 57 for that matter. Mm. So it can't be as hectic. There's no struggle. The struggle ended on 9th October 1962. The only struggle you've just talked about to losing your hair in the course of manufacturing other people, isn't it? Now, that part of it was the struggle in the labor ward.
Yeah.
The rest will be annual celebrations of what caused the hair to fall out. But the hair won't fall out again. Okay? So, if
unless
you,
I decide to
again. And that's up to you. But now your children will have heard about how you lost that's hair, but they won't lose their hair because it's your birthday.
But can they relate?
Yes, they can, but not in labor pains. Okay? So the issue of Dr. Obote, Sir Edward Mutesa, and others, what they went through to make 9th October 62 a reality, cannot be reenacted at all. That is a closed chapter. Now, how you celebrate is another matter. Our independence in this country was not about shedding blood, really. It was a discussion with the people who had taken it.
Yeah.
And that discussion ended in an agreement that 9th October 62 should be the day when the Muzungu agrees to hand over what they had taken away. In Kenya, it was slightly different because they went to war, they killed quite a number of people, imprisoned others. Even here, some people went to prison. We are about to celebrate the memory of Ignatius Musazi, one of the people who actually went to prison because of telling the Wazungu to go away. People like Yekosofati Engur from Lango and many others. Sir Edward Mutesa himself had to go to prison. He was lucky he was imprisoned in London, not your Buluzira. They took him to London.
He was eating sausage for breakfast.
Well, you might think he preferred to eat sausages there, but I think there were sausages here. But in 1953, they put him on a plane and took him to prison in London because of talking about freedom and other things. So that chapter ended.
Yes.
So today, we are not looking for independence again. We are looking for other things. And you will see, governments since that time have also given people reason not to celebrate. A few years ago, the celebrations were compulsory, especially for people working in government. If you are not seen to be very actively involved, you could be suspected of other things. So you rather be seen there. Today, yeah,
you
either there or you are not, and
no one cares.
There's no one who has that type.
Yeah, your transport allowance will not be cut. Or your lunch.
Now they could play you a trick and give it there. So if you are not there,
they don't get it.
Yeah, but the hectic aspects of it has gone. The truth is, it has gone.
It has gone.
Yeah, it has gone.
That ship sailed. So my worry is, if the ship starts to sail and it's 58, only 58 years, only 58 years, 57. I mean, 57, well, yeah, to be exact, 57 years. What will happen if we clock 150? Will we even remember about Ugandan independence? Will our children remember? Because for me, losing the sense of independence is this. I can't downplay the importance of independence. Yeah, you said there was no actual bloodshed, but getting our country back to us, I can imagine if we were still under the European rule, that would be another story.
There is no government in Uganda which will ignore the Independence Day of the country because it's the birthday. I myself at times remember a day after that it was 23rd March. Mine. There are times I say, Kumbe, my birthday was yesterday. Because I am not the one who gave birth to myself. Okay? And because of things that are happening here and there, I find the day has passed. But it does not remove the day. So this celebration aspect is not as important as you think. If you decide to ignore it, then you must find another day which you prefer to celebrate. But you will never have a second birthday. Never. So those who willfully choose to forget it are free. And there's something I haven't told you.
Please tell me.
Don't think every Ugandan wanted independence. No. There are people who said, if we get independence at the same time with this Baganda, I'm telling you, this Baganda will... there's a four-lettered word which I don't want to use.
We'll blip.
Oh, on our heads. The others who said, let it delay until we have also reached a certain level.
Yeah.
So don't think everybody was excited about 9th October 1962. Two, some of our areas, like where I come from, we were colonized by Baganda.
Yes.
And we sort of got our independence also from them.
Wow.
In eastern Uganda, the trailblazers were Kakunguru, representing the British.
Yeah.
That's how we started ruling Basoga, the Bagisu, Iteso, Samia. The official language there became Luganda. Okay? So when you talk about losing freedom and you are in eastern Uganda, you are talking about losing it first to Kakunguru, then two to the Wazungu. So there are people who also in Bunyoro, they still talk about the day they could get a little more independent from Buganda because the land titles in the lost counties belong to Luswata. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So how do they relate? So how do they relate independence when their land titles are with Luswata?
Yeah.
But it is also 9th October. So let's not forget that not everybody was excited about 9th.
There was the
fear
of the unknown. Oh, wow. Oh. Oh, my. You see, I had absolutely no idea about this. My history teacher, bring back my money.
Thank you.
Bring back my money.
It was your parents' money.
Bring back my father's money. How dare you not tell me things as important as these? You guys, wow. Nayaba Ganga, won't be you come at me?